In the last tutorial, I finished describing the features of the Paint the Screen interface of the Record Format Generator. In this tutorial, I will introduce the Checkbox Edits interface and go over the first category, Display Edits. Every field in a record format has a long list of properties that controls how that field behaves. These properties are changed in the Checkbox Edits interface, which can be reached in several ways. The easiest is to highlight the field you want to modify and press Ctrl E, which instantly brings up the Checkbox Edits window. The option to open the Checkbox Edits window also appears on the menu that comes up when you right-click on a field, and finally in the View menu as well. Once the Checkbox Edits window is open, you can switch to any field in the format either by using the drop-down menu or clicking on the new field directly. The Checkbox Edits window is always open to the highlighted field. You can even choose to view the Checkbox Edits for a tag-only field. Most of the options do not apply, and the ones that do are all in the same category, Display. The display options, as the name implies, control the way a field is displayed. Most of these options are settable from the Paint the Screen interface and are here for convenience. The first four options are informational. You cannot change them from this window. Field number is the internal number Unibase assigns a field so that it can be uniquely referenced by programmers. Fields are numbered from left to right and top to bottom, so you could work it out yourself, but this is still here as a reminder. A record format could have up to 999 fields, which is a ridiculous number, but it's available. Column and row simply remind you where a field is located. They're measured in characters. A record format is limited to 80 columns. It can have almost any practical number of rows, but as mentioned in the last tutorial, only 22 rows are visible at a time in data entry. Tag is an easy way to identify which field you're working on. It shows you the tag of the field in question. Length can be useful if you're squinting to make sure you have enough characters in your fields. It can also be changed if you want to round off a field without counting characters by clicking on the value and then typing in a new one. Be careful though, if you make a field too long, it can spill over onto the next line, or worse, be covered by a later field. A covered field will still work, but is a guaranteed way to confuse both yourself and your keyers. Non-display field is a choice. You assign a new value by choosing it from the drop-down menu that appears when you click on the old value. When it's set to yes, a keyer will not see the field in data entry. The field has to be filled by field edit. Tag attributes and field attributes allow you to control the color of a field after it has been placed. Tag and field color were discussed in the previous tutorial. Scrolling fields is very complicated. It is so complicated that I am going to defer a discussion of its use to a future tutorial. Just to tease you, I'll tell you that scrolling fields are used with very short, very repetitive record formats. Used properly, they let the keyer see multiple records on the screen at one time as an aid to avoid losing their place on the form. If you do not have a situation like that, I encourage you to move on to the next tutorial, Type Edits, the most commonly used checkbox edit.